is up, guys? Jake here with another Vainglory gameplay video, and this one's going to be a little different. I've been wanting to do this since I realized that it could be done. The guild is basically full at this point, so we're having a lot of guild-on-guild scrimmages just playing for fun, and that's exactly what we've got going here. I am not in the match. I'm a spectator, so bear with me. Don't know how it's going to go. I'm going to be trying to learn the controls as far as how to move around the map and what we can see and how to bring this to you guys the best I can on the fly. Never done it before, never practiced, but I think it's going to be a fun way for you to see gameplay a little differently. You know, I've seen them do this on the streams and stuff. Obviously, you can move around the map, watch the different fights, and I can just comment on it without being in the match myself and having to worry about what I'm doing. Just focusing on the match, I think it's going to be an interesting way to bring you guys Vainglory content. So here we go. We've got Catherine, Taka, and Celeste versus Celeste, Catherine, and Krul. So pretty even match as far as the heroes go. Only one variation, and you see all the players there. We've got Kendall, Muffin Man, Noob, Helios, Jay's Move, and Dr. Something or another. I didn't catch that. So let me see if I can figure out how to do this here. I don't know how to zoom out, really. Obviously, they're just starting normal stuff here. They're going to farm. On the other side here, same thing. Celeste going up the lane. Taka going down to grab a farm there, and that is that. I know that you can zoom out and then look at this whole map, and I don't know how to do it. Nothing I seem to be doing right here is working. Let's watch. The lane's going to be the first engagement, obviously. We'll watch that with Celeste on Celeste, and Helos going right at it, very aggressive on that, just going in and poking Celeste on the opposite side really quickly, but right away backing out. Here we might have a skirmish really early down here at the bottom. Taka's down here. Here comes Catherine and Krul. Taka retreats, just goes back to the farm, so nothing too eventful down here. We'll go back up to the lane. Kendall Celeste has pushed in, got Helo back. Ooh, nice drop there. What do you call that? Is that a Helo? Whatever it is, drop it right on top of that Celeste and pushing her back even further. Again, maybe if I can find a way to control this map more in the future, it will be better. I'll do my best. Bear with me while it's jerking around right here, guys. I'm just trying to watch the mini map. You can see down at the bottom too. What's interesting is you can see the kills, the gold. You can see what everyone's building. You see that right here, another fight going in the lane. Ooh, Helos might be pushing too hard. Might get stuck right here. Oh, missed the stun. Oh no, did get it from one of the minions. I think got her. So right there, Celeste with the advantage coming in and going to start putting some damage in on this turret right away. But down here on the bottom, you can see what each team's building. You can see their kills. You can see their health. All that good stuff. So that's very, very cool, I think, that we can watch it this way. Celeste gets in, gets actually poked a little bit by the turret there. I don't know what she did to aggro that. Maybe there wasn't a minion in range. That's pretty much all that's going on up there. We'll look back down here in the jungle real quick. You've got, oop, they're coming up for a gank here. Here we go. It's going to be a gank possibility. Got the nice stun. Here comes Krul coming in. I think they've probably got her right there. If Krul uses his B ability, it's going to be all over. Boom, it's down. Right here, they're going to be able to push into that turret, all three of them right there really quickly. If Taka and Catherine do not come up and help, they're going to have a good chance to take down this turret or at least get a hefty amount of damage put on it really quickly. Right there, the last minion goes down. Their wave's coming in. I'm really surprised that Krul and Catherine peeled out right there. They had a perfect opportunity to put some damage on this turret, and Celeste is left by herself to do it. So we'll see how much damage she gets done. Not a whole lot. Going to have to back off Celeste from the red team coming back up and obviously going to run her off here, get her out of the way. Actually, she's going to stand there and take it. That's not real smart. That turret's going to target her. Here comes the Taka for a gank. Probably going to get this gank right here. Yep, that's that. A little too aggressive there. It's going to cost. Ooh, she's going to get away now. She got it. Just a little too aggressive, stayed too long at that turret and cost her a death there. And now let's see if they're going to be smart and stay. Catherine's already peeling off. Taka's peeling off. Why are these guys not going for these turrets? They're wide open. They got the wave right there. Wow. Okay, we're going to have a fight down here, though. Oh, nope. There they went. I thought we were going to have a fight in the jungle, but they just separated long enough. Celeste really doing some work on this turret, though. That's very cool. So she's probably going to get that. See, that's right there. That was smart. The wave gets out of the way. Celeste is coming back. Doesn't stay too long. Doesn't stay too aggressive. Just gets back and tries to poke in, take out all those minions so that her minions can move forward. But Helios is back up and chasing Celeste off. So right here, they'll have a little bit of jabbing back and forth, seeing what they can do. Down in the jungle, blue team's at the store. and the red team is just doing their normal farm stuff. Let's see on the farm right now, slight advantage for the red team as far as gold. You can see if they're at the very top, guys. It shows how many turrets they've got, how much gold the team has farmed, and how many kills each team has. So you see that they're at 2.3K, 800 gold as a team ahead of the blue team. Not a big deal, but you know, can make a difference, especially late game. Sorry, I'm getting some lag here, obviously. You see that sort of, you know, taking a moment to catch back up, but a little bit of a skirmish going on. These Celeste are just going back and forth. It's just a jousting for position and who can get that poke off right there. Nice stun on Celeste, but didn't get much more out of it than that stun. Really, Helios needs to go back to the store, to the house, and get healed up if he can. We got the red team moving up, possibly trying to get a gank here. We'll see what Taka and Catherine can do, if they can sneak in. Nice little poke there by Blue Celeste. Right there, here comes Catherine for the stun. Again, I start lagging. Sorry about that. Does get the gank on Celeste. Very nice there. But the blue team also rotates up and runs them off of the turret. So very good job coming up, sneaking in, and getting that kill by Taka and Catherine. All right, that'll probably be that. They're going to go back to the store. Looks like the whole red team's retreating back. Interesting. Blue team's just getting back to the farm down here in the jungle. Let's look at some stats here. Down at the bottom, you see that Celeste on the red's got 2 kills, 1 death, 1 assist. 0-0-1 for Taka and 1-0-0 for Catherine. On the blue team, no kills, no deaths, 1 assist for Krul, 0 kills, 3 deaths, 0 assists for Catherine, and 1-0-0 for Celeste, and 1-0-0 for Catherine there. Right here, we got some action going on in the lane. Helios, again, pushing very hard, being very aggressive in this fight. Constantly getting into that range of that turret, taking a shot and having to back off, plus getting an ability is called a helo. I can't remember if that's right. That's not good. Again, too aggressive. Got in range. If you hit someone in range of that turret, it's going to target you. And then she was able to drop that A ability on there, and that was that. So another kill. Now Celeste is going to be able to, if she can get this wave out of the way quickly, going to be able to move forward and put some more damage on that turret, probably before the blue Celeste gets back there in time. Down in the jungle, not a lot of activity down in the jungle. We might see a fight right here shaping up. Both teams close to the store here. Nope, blue team's just moved on, started back to their farm. Red team is doing the same. So right here, let's see, we got Celeste finally getting in there, putting a little bit of damage on this turret, trying to get those minions out of the way. Blue Celeste has made it back though, and here they come, possibly a gank opportunity here. Got the stun off. If Catherine can get that stun, they're going to get her right there. Yep, she's going down. Ooh, yep, she got it. Right there, Catherine comes in, tries to save her, but too little too late. Here comes Taka. Is Taka going to get Blue Celeste? I believe he will. Yep, right there, got it taken care of. Ooh, Taka almost went down himself though. So a little bit of a lane fight there. You see 5 kills on the red team to 2 on the blue team. So really, kill-wise, advantage for the red team. But look at the gold. Blue team has caught up and passed the red team, 3.9 to 3.8K. Not a lot happening. Just back to the farm here on the blue team side. And same for the red team. They had to recover from that skirmish that they lost. But Catherine's just back in the jungle, doing her farm thing. So right here, blue team cycling back down to the store. Let's see what they're all building up here. That's one thing we haven't looked at much. You got Catherine pretty much straight defense. You've got Celeste in the lane going crystal power, but also with some attack speed. And you've got the Krul going with attack speed. That's reuse speed. What's that called there? Can you remember that end on ability? And then some armor defense. So pretty no high damage output builds really right now for the blue team. Looking at the red team, you've got Celeste, which I believe that's an Eve of Harvest already. She got so hanging in there, not buying anything except for that Eve of Harvest. So very interesting there. You've got Taka with a tension bow and 1 crystal bit, and you've got Catherine. Ooh, we had a fight down here and I missed it. Sorry guys, I was reading that stuff and didn't see it. Looks like Krul and Catherine took out Catherine down there on the blue team. But Catherine building just some crystal power and a little bit of life, extra life there. So nothing too aggressive as far as the builds go here. It looks like the blue team is going to grab this gold mine, depending on here. If they notice it right here, they could probably get last hit if they go for it. Boom, who got it? Nope, blue team did get it, but they paid with their lives right there. Taka and Celeste taking them out right there as the gold mine falls to the blue team. So very cool. Really getting out ahead as far as the kills go. 8-3 at this point, and they have retaken the lead as far as team gold mined and collected. 5.9 to 5.3K. It looks like in the lane, Celeste is going to stay down here in the jungle with her team, and that's leaving the lane wide open. Catherine up here is going to start trying to clear these minion wave out to get in there and get to that turret, but finally Catherine comes back up, gets a stun off, and drops an helo on her, getting her run off, doing quite a bit of damage there. Blue team Catherine returns the favor as far as the stun goes, and I get more lag. Sorry about that, guys. Looks like he's probably going to get taken out here. Got taken out there. Very nice kill by red team Catherine. She's winning sort of the battle up there, but very low life on her own. They're going to clear all this wave out and probably try to push this second turret. It looks like all three of them are up there. They do have a pretty fresh wave to do it if they want to. Nope, Catherine's going back, so they're going to peel out and head back to the jungle. Catherine and Krul are down here at the store. They better wake up because there's about to be a fight, whether they know it or not. Taka, am I lagging? Yeah, right there. Ooh, Taka just got smoked. Come into that. Maybe it wasn't ready for it. A very nice job by Krul there, wrapping back around the backside of Catherine, getting that ultimate stun off, and then those two just take her out very quickly. So nice, nice couple of kills there in the jungle for the blue team. Same going on in the lane. They're going to come in and invade the blue team's, or excuse me, the red team's jungle, try to take some of their farm, obviously, get control of that. They're very even right now on the gold for each team right now. We think we got a fight going on up top here. Ooh, got an ultimate off on Catherine there. Didn't do a whole lot of damage. Doesn't have her turret here. This is probably not a good fight for Helios, not having their turret there. Just stayed in again. A little bit too aggressive up there. 10-5 on the kills now. Let's see if this fight's going to happen down here in the jungle. Nope. Taka and Catherine come in and pretty much just run Krul and Catherine off of their jungle. But the damage is done. They got the farm and really, really close again. Oop, here we go. We're going to have a fight right here. Catherine comes in. Taka jumps on her. Let's see. Ooh, Krul is really putting the hurt on Taka in these group fights. Really targeting him well and taking him down very, very quickly. As he got that B ability, yep, right there. Boom, goes down. Taka down. And looks like Catherine. Nope. Celeste comes in and saves Catherine. Very, very nice there. Going to run him off, get him back up to their side. And I guess I would back off here, but maybe they're going to continue on chasing them down. Right there, gets the stun on Catherine. If they had a target separate people there, had Krul targeted Catherine on the red team, would have been down and still might get her in the end. Celeste goes down right there. Very nice fight there. And Catherine is going to peel out and go back to the house. So the map is theirs if they want it. We'll see what they make of it. They're just running down to the store right now. I probably would have invaded and grabbed some more of their farm and tried to starve them for gold there. But they're just going to do a little shopping and then get back to it. Right here, we're going to have a possible gank in the lane. Taka right there. I don't know why. Helios, you got it. When you see that, you got to get out of there, man. I think Taka's definitely going to get this kill. Yep, get that kill. That is, let's see, 9 deaths for Blue Team Catherine. Tough match for Helios for sure. Let's see. Got a fight probably going to go down here in the jungle. Nope, Catherine's going up top. Here we go. Yep, definitely going to be an engagement. Taka's coming in. He sees Krul and tries to get out of there. Again, nice stun right there. Landed on Taka as he was trying to escape. Takes him out. Celeste coming down. They're going to be at 2-on-2. Sorry about the lag, guys. It's just what happens with this crappy internet of mine. Not very eventful. They pretty much both teams just go their separate ways there. So very nice kill again on Taka. Let's look at some more stats here. Taka doing pretty good, though. 4 kills, 3 deaths, 1 assist. The kills, it looks a little more lopsided than it actually is. I mean, I think that the red team's winning most of these, but only 8-11 on the total kills. Nice ultimate there by Celeste. Got a good fight going here. Ooh, looks like the blue team, having the advantage of 3-on-2, is going to win this one. Taka in the jungle doing his farm thing. You got to be careful not to leave your team exposed like that. Again, I am sorry about the lag, guys. Maybe I'll try to do this at times when my internet is performing a little bit better. But Celeste still coming up, going to fight. Probably not the best idea. Whoa, did you see Taka come flying in there? Not sure. I think that was more of my lag. But right there, God, this is so... Every time a group fight breaks out, this happens. I'm sorry, guys. Right there, Taka does go down. And I believe... No, I'm sorry. Taka's still up. Taka evaded there. Who went down? I'm sorry. The lag got to me. It looks like Catherine and Celeste from the blue team both went down. So red team definitely, again, getting the best of that team fight. 13-9 as far as that goes. And look at the gold, though. Very interesting. They're up almost 2,000 gold, the blue team is. This could, for late game, make all the difference if they continue to have that lead. Celeste taking care of that. Red team getting back to farming in the jungle, which is smart. They've got to close that gap as far as the gold grab. Let's see here. Celeste actually calls back, doesn't worry about it. They're going to have to just clear out that wave in their own jungle, and then we'll see what happens if we get another skirmish down here as far as when the blue team and red team meet up towards the middle of the jungle here. Catherine and Taka, looks like they're probably going to stop off. Ooh, nice scout mine there. They've got vision on them now. They know where they're at. Here they come. Krul and Catherine probably going to engage here, jumping on to Taka there, gets the stun, second stun's down, that is it. Taka is done, and Catherine pulls the pin. She's not going to take a death for Taka after he was already pretty much in trouble there. So that scout mine really was the story there. They had the vision on them, they could see that they were there, and now they're going to come in and take their minion mine. We had a fight going on in the lane here. Again, Helios right in front of that turret. I really don't understand that fighting her in front of her own turret. It's fine if you want to fight out in the middle, but here she's clearly got the advantage. A few shots, the ultimate goes off, and that's probably going to be another death for Helios. We will see. Still trying to fight her off. Should have just ran, but dies there in the lane. Right here, but the blue team does come up to try to protect her a little bit late, but they might get Celeste out of this deal. Catherine trying to save her, take the hits. Here comes Taka flying in. Does put some hard damage onto Catherine. Should have been targeting Krul there probably. Would have probably got the kill had he targeted that. Catherine's awful tanky to be trying to take out like that. Excellent. Wow. What use of his abilities there by Krul. Dr. Pimper is playing really, really well on Krul out there. I'm impressed. He was pretty much dead, but had built up a few hits onto Taka there. Used his A ability, which gave him a temporary shield or absorbs a damage, whatever you want to call it. And then as he got those abilities built up, uses that B ability, which gives him some lifesteal. Charges him back up. Catherine comes flying in with an ultimate. Probably not the best use of that ultimate. But right here, going to have a 2-on-1. Not going to end well for Celeste in the lane for sure. She's going to... Oh, wow. They come in just in time. Celeste actually lived through that. I can't believe it. I thought she was for sure going to go down. They are chasing the other Celeste off, but she wisely retreats back to her turret. Here comes Taka for reinforcement. Again, Taka is targeting Catherine too often, in my opinion. There's really no benefit to Taka hitting Catherine. He's not going to burst her down. I know she's low life, but she's got so many abilities that she can sort of survive that. Right there, finally gets on Celeste. That was smart. One more hit on Celeste, and she's going to go down. She's down. Catherine's low life. They've got to retreat here. Again, I think probably the red team getting the best out of these exchanges. The gold lead is just widening, though. The blue team, 14.6K, 11.1 for the red team. So they're getting more and more ahead on the gold grab. We will see how this affects late game. Probably mostly because they've held the gold mine for almost the entire match, I think. Right here, the red team calling back, getting set up. Probably not the best time to call back when the Kraken just spawned. It would be kind of a mistake to go that early for the Kraken, but I think they're going to do it. The blue team is calling for it. I think they're going to go for the Kraken. Oh, nope, someone's telling them don't do it. Someone's smart. If they had all three there, they might have had a chance with them calling back, but I think both teams playing it a little bit safer than that. Just going to fall back here. Only one turret taken out so far. The red team's first turret has been damaged. Not too bad, though. It's still in pretty good shape, so there's still some work to be done there. Both teams just farming in the jungle. Celeste up top farming in the lane, and the blue team starting to stick together here. With that first turret down, they're just sort of running together. Right here, we've got a really high chance of getting Celeste here. She is way out there. Doesn't even know they're there. Yep, she's in trouble. This one's done. They're going to stun. They're going to take her out. Where is Celeste over here? Bad ultimate there. That was not a good shot for an ultimate. Shooter just came in and been poking on her. She might accidentally escape from this. Nope, right there. Catherine gets the stun and gets taken out. Yes, absolutely. Got to get that minion mine, or excuse me, that turret taken care of. Get that wave of minions out of the way. As soon as your minions come in, try to grab this turret and even the score. Here comes Taka and Catherine right there. Again, Taka jumping onto Catherine. Got to pick a different target. Come in with your invisibility. Pick a squishier target than Catherine when you go in on that. Krul and Catherine on the blue team putting some good damage down on the red Catherine. Taka finally getting on a squishy target. Celeste getting the kill right there. So Celeste goes down again, then wisely retreating back to their turret for safety. Let's see here. It looks like, yeah, Catherine's really having a rough match on the blue team. One kill, 13 deaths, 2 assists. So we'll see what they do here. They're just getting back into the jungle. Probably going to get back to farming. If I was red team Catherine, I probably would have went back to the house, healed up, and just got back in the fight. There's no sense in walking around with that low of life, honestly. Sorry about the lag again, guys. Nothing I can do about it. Let me see if I can actually turn some Wi-Fi off on some other devices. Maybe that will help us. All right, where are we at here? See, Catherine's back up in the lane. She's going to try it again. She just got killed going too far like that. We'll see if she learns her lesson or if she goes for it again. Trying to keep those minions cleared out of the way. Sorry, guys. This lag is really bad. Let me try to turn this off here. Maybe that'll help. All right, coming in, she's going to try to push this turret. She's getting in a fight with Blue Team Catherine here, and really no one has the advantage in the situation simply because of the fact that they are out in the lane. No one's turret is nearby. God, I am so sorry about this lag, guys. I will try to do something to improve this. This might be server side. This might be me. I'm not sure. I'll have to check into it when I do a few more of these, maybe off of off video. This is my first time doing it. Right there, red team cat Celeste takes care of blue team, sort of has to run her off, and now gets going to get some work done on this turret. Possibly even get the kill. Yep, got the kill right there. Here comes blue team Catherine though, and Krul. They're obviously going to get that gank. Very nice. Red team Celeste has, I'm sorry about it, I keep saying Catherine and Celeste. Red team Celeste has no choice really but to push into that lane as far as she can, unless she just wants to run around with her red team cohorts that are just farming in the jungle right now. 17,000 to 14,000 on the gold grab. So blue team still the advantage there, but red team with a slight advantage on kills, 17 to 14. At this point in the game, though, we're at 19 minutes. These deaths are going to start being more and more severe if it continues like it has been. In early game, those deaths don't mean a whole lot. I mean, they do, but it's easy to recover from them. You're not going to have a big problem. An ace right here or two members of a team dying right here is going to be pretty big. Could have a potential a fight right here in the middle of the jungle. They are going to. They're running to each other at the store. Again, the lag comes as soon as the fight breaks out. I'm terribly sorry, guys. We can't hardly even see what happens when that goes down. But the blue team really getting the better of this one. Catherine goes down, and now they're chasing down Taka. Probably not going to catch Taka, but did get the damage is done there. And the wave, just the normal minion wave, takes out their turrets. So now we're even on turrets. The kills aren't that very far apart. And blue team, again, still has the advantage as far as gold. So let's see. Oh, they're going for the Kraken. Didn't even see that. And I don't think the red team does either. They are going to get the Kraken. No question. The red team pressing the turrets, and now they've got a Kraken unleashed. Interesting. Let's see how the red team reacts here. They're actually staying on this turret up here. They're going to continue to try to take it down. I think they're going to get it. Yep. Enemy turret destroyed. Let's see. Are they going to continue to push, or are they going to go fall back and fight the Kraken? Probably at this point, yep. Calling back. Going to start fighting that Kraken, trying to fight it off. Krul going down, taking out the red team's minion mine, so they're going to have that advantage. And here you're about to see a 3-on-3 fight, no question about it. Everyone's coming into this turret. Kraken's coming in. We'll see who gets the advantage. An ace here would be huge for the blue team. So right here, they're coming out. Ooh, nice ultimate. Very nice ultimate there. Got an early advantage there. Taka's almost dead. The turret's getting beat on. Ooh, right there, Krul's in trouble. I'm telling you, that Krul right there has done so well on his ability used to keep him alive in fights like that. Very, very impressive. Catherine pushing probably a little bit too far in. Right here, Celeste needs to try to poke in and take those last little bit out. One turret down. They're easily going to press to this next turret, but Taka's up and back in the fight. Ooh, takes out Celeste on the blue team very quickly and is going to run Catherine off for sure. Now they're going to be able to deal with that Kraken, and it's only going to get the one turret. So not bad defense there by the red team. Guys, I see this all the time in fights when Kraken comes in, people focus on the Kraken and ignore the team that is attacking with the Kraken. Obviously, the threat from the team is much greater than the Kraken itself. So remember that. Try to make sure you're winning the fight, then worry about taking that Kraken out. So red team retreats back. Blue team's got a couple of deaths. He's going to talk about the longer deaths there. That's a pretty pivotal fight right there for the red team. They're almost caught up on the gold grab here. 18.6 to 19.3 and four kills ahead with two dead right now at this moment. So really a chance for the red team to recover. Group back up. See what they look at this lag on this. God, I'm so sorry, guys. I don't know what to do. I might try the next one on my other internet connection and see if it performs a little better. So they're going to grab their minion mine back. And just again, they're grouped up here. The turrets are both on both teams are pushed back to the base areas. That third turret, they only got three each. So really the fights are going to happen much more often as a 3 versus 3. And no longer are you going to see the lanes being pushed separately from the group fight. So right here, just trying to clear that wave out of the way. The blue team is coming up. About to have a 3-on-3. There's no question about it. Catherine's setting up, waiting on her team to come in. Here comes Krul. He's waiting for that ability that lets him pounce out of the jungle. And right here we go. Ultimate goes out. Got his ultimate on Taka there, but so much damage come from Red Celeste there. Krul goes down. Catherine's in trouble. Celeste is going down. This is going to be an ace for the red team. Wow. Very, very nice. Pivotal ace for the red team. No question. They are going to push into this turret here. I'm not sure what. They're going to the store. That's interesting there. I don't know that I would do that. I would have pushed right in, grabbed that minion mine, and tried to get this third turret taken care of. We'll see what happens here if Celeste on her own can do it. Just trying to get those minions out of the way. So she has a second wave coming right behind there. That's going to help. She's going to easily get some damage on this turret here. You see 23 seconds before even Krul gets up. These late game aces like that just probably clinched the win for the red team there. You see, they've overtaken the blue team on gold at this point, 23,000 to 19,000 and 7 kills, really dominating right now. So probably going to be the end of it. Obviously, they need to get in here. They're waiting for that second wave. Or third wave, I guess. Now, right there, here comes another wave. Krul is up, but a few more seconds on Catherine and Celeste. So we'll see what they do. Probably going to be another fight right here. Krul sort of waiting for his team, trying to bait him into range of those turrets. They've got to get this wave out of the way, which they do. Ooh, interesting ultimate there by Celeste on the blue team. Celeste on the red team could be in trouble if they get one more stun off on her. Taka, ooh, very, very nice. Puts a lot of damage down on Krul. Sorry again, as soon as we get something interesting. Right there, Krul does go down. Very interesting fight right there. Taka absolutely just sort of took that one over, put it on his shoulders, and pushed the blue team right back into their base. Took out Krul and Celeste. Now they've got a chance to take out these turrets and really cap the game off. 45 seconds before Catherine is not on her own. They really need to press the advantage here, let this next wave come in, and then try to get at least one more turret out of this. Oh, wow, Catherine is going back. Taka's already back. Left Celeste on her own. Such an advantage there. Ooh, man, very surprising. Very surprising. I think there's no doubt they could have taken that, just waited for a fresh wave to come in and went for it. So now Celeste is on her own fighting Catherine. Again, the lag starts. This is very, very frustrating for me, and I'm sorry for you guys. I know it's not what, you know, every time a fight breaks out, we sort of just see the aftermath and not the action. Not at all what I want, but hopefully I can figure it out and get it better. Hopefully this is not something on the server side. It is my internet that I can address. Right here, as Taka and Catherine are about to rejoin the fight, Krul and Celeste from the blue team are back up, so a very wasted advantage right there, and a huge late-game ace, and they just sort of went back to the house and did shopping and got healed up instead of pressing the issue here. So a second fight's breaking out. Looks like the blue team's going to have the advantage on this one. A nice stun there. Come back and take out Celeste. They need to be targeting Celeste there. Taka had already ran off. He comes back into the fight. We lag out. We'll see what happens here. As soon as we catch up, all we're going to catch is the aftermath, unfortunately. Oh, man. Look at this. What happens? What happens? Wow, they're still all alive here. Wow, who went down there? Oh, Celeste on the blue team goes down. Taka's look like he's going to be in trouble right there. Yep, Taka goes down 2-on-2 at this point. Krul and Catherine versus Catherine and Celeste. They are retreating. A very nice poke there by Celeste to get Catherine out of those, Krul out of that jungle and push them back into their own jungle. Now they're going to try to get their minion mind back, start to recover here. Both teams sort of go into their corners, getting ready for an ultimate fight towards the end. I still believe that was a huge mistake on the red team's part. They had the advantage. They had them down to a 3-on-1. They had both minion minds, and they go back all the way back to their base. I think they could have had the win there. Maybe I'm wrong. 25,000 to 22,000, but the big story here, 25 to 16 on the kills. Unbelievable how many more group fights and skirmishes that the red team has won. Look at all these minions that they had built up from that huge wave of having both minion mines. They wisely come back and clear all that out. You don't want all those minions coming in and working on your turrets. So they're going to get that cleared out of the way. We're going to get another lag spike for absolutely no reason. And then hopefully, we'll have a good bit of internet here when the next group fight breaks out. Again, both teams just sort of in their corners, getting regrouped, probably buying different abilities, getting their final builds built up. Everybody level 12 at this point. Again, in the slight gold advantage now, really cut back on the gold advantage. When you have all of those minions coming in like that, though, and you take them all out, that's a lot of gold. So you are giving them that advantage. Let's see if they go for the Kraken here. Nope, they're just coming through. Going to grab this minion mine, but they are going to encounter a fight here. Obviously, I lagged out there, but Catherine walks right by them, jumping onto Krul. He takes it pretty well, though. Catherine's the one taking the brunt of that one. Celeste goes down. She's dying just way too often in this match. 19 deaths. That's crazy. Taka in a lot of bad trouble here. He's got to retreat. Blue team is taking it back 2-2 here. Right there, Taka got, oh my goodness, it's 1-on-1. Celeste and Krul, I don't think Krul can chase Celeste here, though. If he does, he's going to die. She can just poke him and kite him, so he wisely backs out. There's just no way he can take her 1-on-1 when she's playing it right, like she did there. So very good, very interesting fight there. I thought that red team was going to crush it, and then blue team got that clutch kill on Taka and took out most of their damage. And that was that. Catherine goes down, and now he's going to come back and try it again. Is he going to be able to get on top of her here? No stuns really besides his ultimate. Right there, he does get the ultimate off. Can he get a few more? Oh, he should have went for it. If he had his B ability up, he could have rushed in with that A ability. I think he could have took her out there. Very nice ultimate, though, by Celeste. That is going to send Krul all the way back to his camp. She gets the minion mine, so sort of wins the day there. But now both teams about to have full strength again. Just a few more seconds. Everyone's going to be up, and we will see what happens in this next group fight. Again, any ace at this point is going to be so pivotal. Could change the outcome of the match. Blue team needs the ace. If red team gets the ace, probably GG. So right here, Krul probably should have already been back at the house and getting his life back up, but he's got some pretty good abilities to get that back up. If he'll just take out this minion mine with his B ability, he should be pretty much healed up. There he goes. He's got it almost back to full. So they're going to grab their minion mine back and get back to work. Again, guys, I know I've said it a million times, but I don't know what to say about this lag. I am sorry. I do have terrible internet. Look at this, though. They're on the crack, and red team is backdooring them. This could be a huge mistake by the blue team. I don't know if they saw them. Surely by now they're hitting their minions. They can see them on their map. They're taking out the Kraken, but it's going to be too little too late. There's no – watch how quickly these turrets go down. They better be calling back to the house right this second and getting back. Otherwise, the Vayne is not going to be there when they return. Right there, Krul's back. Let's see if the other teams follow. Here they come. They have a chance here to fight them off and get them back, and this will be big because the Kraken's going to be marching towards their base. Right there, they did take out – who was that? Taka goes down. So now it's just about getting Celeste out of the way. Can the blue team get her? I think they're going to. Come on, if Celeste comes over and targets her here, right there, Celeste could go down. Red team Celeste is down. This is huge. What an ace. They've got a Kraken down there about to start beating on the, oh my goodness, on the turret. This is going to be the greatest comeback I've ever seen in this game if they win this. They have been getting dominated for most of the game. They've got a Kraken at the turret that is going to be obviously taking this one out. They've got 29 seconds before the first player gets up. No reason this shouldn't be a win right here for the blue team. And if so, again, what an amazing comeback. I thought it was a mistake. Oh, what are you doing down there? Forget about the minion. Go for it. Oh, no. If they're going for the minion mine. Huge mistake there. They should be forcing this. 12 seconds and Taka's going to be up. They should have been on these turrets as fast as possible. And then obviously that Vayne to try to take it out. They are going to have about 3 or 4 seconds before Taka gets up here. Let's see what he can do once he gets up. Celeste dropping her ultimate, trying to get these turrets down before the teams are fully back to health. Taka is going to take out Celeste on the blue team right there. So nice kill. He let go of it. Should not have changed targets. I should have finished that kill. Looks like now Taka's got to retreat a little bit. Celeste on the blue. Red team is up right there. Too little, too late. Unbelievable. I thought it was a mistake to go for that Kraken, but it paid off huge. They called back, fought off the attack onto their base. Wasn't enough time for the red team to get the turrets down. Epic, epic fight by everyone involved there. Very, very cool. Woo, man, that was awesome. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I enjoy doing it as a spectator and not necessarily in the match. And I've wanted to do this for you guys since I knew it could be done. So if you like it, let me know. I promise you I will try to figure out some way to make the lag less ridiculous than it was in this match. This was sort of a tester. I will test it out off of camera a few times to see if I can improve on it. So let me know down in the comments if you like this, want to see more of it. Until next time, Jake reminding you guys to suck less.